This is... Shady Oaks for shady folks.
Yeah, that's catchy. And true.
Oh, hi, boss. Can I take off this doctor costume? It's got blood all over it.
We need a doctor. It's a medical clinic.
But I'm not a doctor.
But you don't have to be a doctor. Just look like one. I need to bring the lizard. It's such a great game.
Oh! I broke today.
Get the show on the road, people!
Hey, boss, we just got a big fat check for all those times you played in traffic. I seriously did not think that that plan of yours would work.
See? Simple and painless.
How about you stop by the clinic next time you're in the neighborhood?
Jackpot. Bingo. Cha-ching!
Almost time. I have somewhere to be.
Got it.
I'm pissed!
They got you too. That was the Dribbling Smile by the Tumbleweed Twins.
You're rugged, hard as nails. You need clothes that can take the punishment of an honest day's work. I'm not talking skinny jeans, bow ties, and fedoras. You need tough clothes like steel-toed boots and overalls, hard hats and flannel. The kind of clothes we make at Wearhard Industrial Clothing Company. Tough threads for tough people.
Well, this here's your buddy Virgil James, and you're listening to Tumbleweed Radio on KWDKE 93.3. Ride back with us to a simpler time of life on the lonesome trail of big skies and bigger dreams out in the great frontier.
Welcome back. You look pretty good for someone who got run over like 100 times.
I'll be at my niece's quinceañera. guess I could always resort to a light.
Turns out the strip club apparently takes their look but don't touch rule pretty seriously.
I'm really enjoying this.
Perfect.
Jeez, has it already been 3 hours?
Keeping it strange.
Work hard, play hard.
It's surprisingly easy to start a multi-level market.
Trying to drive here!
I hate this!
You must be Barb.
And you must be Kevin's friend. Shall we get started?
Right now? Sure. Where's your crew?
No crew. Just us.
Seriously?
Don't worry. I've got it all worked out. You wait in the car while I grab the jewelry. Then I drive us out.
So you're robbing the store and you're the getaway driver. What am I doing?
I can't drive and shoot at the same time. I need you to ride shotgun.
Well, as far as plans go, I've seen worse. Let's do it. I got you covered. Let's go. You okay?
Never felt better.
Got the jewelry?
It's in the bag. Have a look for yourself.
I'll take your word for it. The cops will be on us soon. Oh, shit. Here they come.
Hang on! I'm ending this now! Keep shooting! I'll get us out of here! Why are they making such a fuss?
On that.
believe the odds are in our favor. Hang on.
Looks like we're in the clear.
Shall I drop you off somewhere?
Nah, right here's fine.
Balsonius, the Dust Smoke calls. I have discovered a way to defeat Gwendolyn Firebird.
Huzzah! We shall finally win the crown and rub it in her ye old face.
I have gathered our forces at the lookout.
We shall be there forthwith.
Always going on the wrong side of the train tracks. Gather round. I have questioned the Law Keeper and found the greatest weapon in all the realms. The Bowel Rod.
This is why you made me come here? I'm out.
Wait, it's a car! Of a sort. You love cars!
Okay. This could be interesting.
Huzzah! I have the perfect costume for you.
Yes. Perfect. Put this here.
I would like the record to show the extent to which I humor my friends.
It hath been noted.
Public Radio. Enriching your day, every day, with classical music. This is Sophia Waters.
Lead the way, Elijah the Wise.
The call has been answered. House Sandy Kraken stands united against the vile Gwendolyn Firebird.
She shall tremble before our collective might.
But first, we must seek out the leader of House Tapeworm. She is the keeper of the Bowery, and we must pay her toll.
Oh my god. What did I sign up for?
Where shall we find this keeper?
Well, I called Fort Tapeworm, but she wasn't there. She's at her house.
And what price does she demand?
A trade. The duct tape we liberated from Fort Tapeworm in exchange for their most sacred weapon.
A sacrifice indeed.
Aye, but worth it.
And what is this bowel rod exactly?
'Tis a great worm that dwells below the desert wastes. The cry of the bowel rod is so mighty, the walls of Fort Thunderpump shall crumble at its sound.
I thought you said it was a car.
For those who don't use their imagination, it is.
Look, Nina, I was pretty skeptical at first, too, but give LARP a chance. I promise it's worth it.
Fine, let's go get this Keeper's Blessing.
Greetings, Keeper of the Bowel Rod. I am Bossonius of House Sandy Kraken.
A new house? Good luck with that. Phoenix and Duststorm have this year locked up. You got my duct tape?
It's in the trunk.
Great! The Bowel Rod's out back. What's your name, dear?
Ninifer Leadfoot.
What? Okay. The Keeper of the Bowel Rod gives Ninifer of House Sandy Kraken her blessing. Go forth and... whatever.
It's a van.
Eli? That's my imagination, but...
What the hell? The deal was the duct tape for the worm.
No one told you. Gwen wanted... You could reassemble it by, I don't know, stealing the props back from...
Housemates, we go to Fort Phoenix to claim what is ours.
Hear, hear.
Now, in typical Gwen fashion, Fort Phoenix is a sprawling, overbuilt compound with a lot of armed guards. So, I propose we use stealth.
Cool, but we wait until nightfall, come in downwind of them.
Oh no, it's not common. You just drink a potion, cross your arms in front, and then boom, you're invisible.
They won't just shoot me?
They can, it's in the rules.
What other rules do we need to know?
If you put your arms down, you'll see. So, that means if you use your weapon or do a melee attack, you lose invisibility.
Then how do I stealth attack?
You can stealth melee as long as no one else sees you. Spot it, and you come.
So what happens if you die?
Then you have to reroll a new character and go back to having zero XP. Sucks. Trust me.
We're here. I've only got the one invisibility potion, so you'll have to go in alone.
Drink up.
Damn it.
shit, it's working. No one!
Arrow to the face.